Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining this session where we'll talk about how you can simplify data discovery with Redshift Query Editor. My name is Uday Narayanan, and I am a Senior Analytics Specialist Solutions Architect at AWS. So let's first level set and talk about what Amazon Redshift is. Amazon Redshift is a fully managed petabyte scale cloud data warehouse. It helps you analyze all your data. So your log files, your transactional data, your clickstream data, semi-structured or even nested data. It is the most affordable cloud data warehouse that delivers better price performance relative to other cloud data warehouses. And it's also easy, secure, and reliable, and you do not have to worry about managing infrastructure. Now, customers usually tell us that they want to promote self-service analytics by empowering their end users, such as data analysts and business analysts, to load data into their analytics platform. For this, you need to make sure that you democratize access while making sure that you're following the principle of least privilege. It is also important to reduce time to insight by ensuring analysts can run SQL queries to analyze and visualize the data, as well as run machine learning-based predictions using just SQL commands. Finally, once they have done the analysis, you need to give them the ability to share it with their teammates so that the teammates can review or reuse those analyses where possible. So this is where Query Editor version 2 comes in, as it accelerates self-service analytics by enabling users to create tables, load data with simple wizards, run analysis, share those analysis with their teammates, and even more capabilities are there. With Query Editor version 2, you can browse schema and tables that you have access to, load data from S3, and even from your local file system using a UI-based interface, and visualize query results with charts right from the Query Editor. You can create notebooks, run multiple queries in the notebook, annotate them, and easily collaborate with your teammates by sharing those notebooks. For accessing the Query Editor, you can integrate it with an identity provider. This means the analysts do not need to access the AWS console, but can directly connect to the Query Editor and run queries. Now, before jumping to the demo, I wanted to quickly talk about one new feature that was recently launched, and that is the ability to load data into Redshift from your local file system. And you can do that using Query Editor as well. So with this, you can load files directly from your computer into a Redshift table, do quick analysis and create charts. And then once you create those charts, you can share it with your teammates. And you don't need to wait for a central ETL team or ETL developer to load the data into the data warehouse, and then you get access to it. So you can do this in a self-service way. All right, so enough talk. Let's see this in action, and let's go into the demo. So this is the Amazon Redshift console in the AWS console. To access the Query Editor version 2, you can click on this, which brings you to the Query Editor tab. I already had the tab open, so I'm going to close this and go here. So here you see that I have a dark background, but if you prefer a lighter background, you can toggle it with this particular button here. I'll keep the dark background because I prefer that. Now here you can see or you have access to the different clusters, the database within the cluster, the schema, the tables. And if you want to look at the table to see what the fields are, the data types, all of that is available from within this UI interface. To connect to a database or to connect to a cluster, I'm already connected, but I'll show you. You have different options. So you can use a federated user option. You can use temporary credentials. You can even do it using a database username and password or a secrets manager. I'm using the temporary credentials, so I'll just save it. So it's going to reconnect to the database. So now we're connected to the database. Now let's see how you can load data into a table. So first step is to create a table, right? So you can use this particular dropdown, and there are different options where you can create a database, a schema, a table, or a function. We'll create a table. So we need to first provide it with the schema and the name of the table. So I'm going to name this table as nation. And then you can add fields manually by clicking this, but I'll actually load it from a CSV file. So you can load from a CSV file and you can browse to that file, and it automatically takes the headers of that file and creates the columns for this table. And then you have the option to change the data type or even the encoding option. I'll keep it as default for now. And then you can also, you know, make a column as not null or make it a primary key or a unique key, and you know, different options here. So for now, we'll just keep everything as default and click on create table. All right, so the table is created. So let's just quickly do a select star from nation and just see what the result looks like. And as expected, it doesn't return any rows because all we have done is created a table. We have not loaded any data. So let's load some data into it. So to load data, you can either use S3 or load it from a local file. If it's S3, you can just provide it with the S3 path. You can browse. I'll just choose a local file because this is a new feature that was recently launched. So I'll browse, go back to the file on my computer. You have the file option where you can select the delimiter or the code character. You can select a compression type, and there are a few different configurations that you can do. Here, I'm going to choose to ignore the header rows because my file has a header row and I don't want the header row to be loaded as a row inside my database or inside my table. So I'm going to say I'm happy with this. And I'm going to select the schema and the table. So this is the nation table that we created just now. And we'll load the data. All right, so it says the loading data was successful. So if I come back here and run the query, the data is available. So you saw how easy it is to create a table from the UI and, you know, load data into it and do some analysis on the data. Now, the next thing is creating an explain plan, right? So here you have the option to run an explain plan on your data. So basically you can toggle the explain option here and then run this query. And it actually showing you what the explain plan for your particular query would look like and how it is going to be executed. You can also see this in a graphical interface where it actually gives you a graphical representation of the explain plan and the steps that go behind running this particular query. Now, once that is done, if you want to run your queries, you can run multiple queries at the same time. So here I have already written two queries. One is the first one is actually getting the quantity sold by month, and the second one is getting the quantity sold by city. And I want to run both the queries at the same time. So I just ran both queries. The first tab here gives me the quantity sold by month, and the second tab gives me the quantity sold by city. Now, let's say if I want to save this for future use, I can go and save this particular query by clicking that button there, and then let's name it sales queries, and then I'll save it. So if I go into the queries tab right here, you will see that my queries, you see this particular query that I had just saved. But if I go into the shared by me or shared to my team, it's actually empty. That's because this query is stored I saved it for myself for use in the future, but I have not shared it with any of my team members. But I can do it by going into this button here and then just say share with my team. So once you do that, and if you go back here, now it tells stop sharing with my team, right? So I don't want to stop sharing. So I'll go back to the queries tab here. And now you see shared by me, the query shows up, and shared to my team, this query shows up as well. Now, if somebody else on my team wrote a query and they share it with the team, those queries will show up here, which I can use to do analysis on it. All right, now let's go into creating charts. So another capability of Query Editor is you can actually create visualizations right from the Query Editor here. So here I have a query where, again, I'm doing a total quantity sold by calendar date. So as you can see, I mean, you have some data for individual days. It's not very friendly to see it in a table format, right? It's easier to see it in a chart format. So we'll go to this toggle button here and create a chart. And we will create a line chart and we'll change this to calendar date. We'll change this to quantity sold. And then we'll go into the transforms and I want to sort this data by calendar date because I want the calendar date to show up in an ascending order. So if I clean this up, you see that I have a data now from January through December and I have this line chart that is created. And then you can choose different chart formats, right? If you want a bar chart or a histogram or a funnel chart, you have those options here. And then this chart can be saved as well. So we can save it, call it my chart and save it. You can also export this particular chart as a PNG or JPEG. The saved chart will show up here under my charts. Okay, another thing that you can do with Query Editor is run parameterized queries. So here I have two tables that I'm joining. But the venue city is a parameter. So when I run this query, it'll ask me for a value. So let's say I say Boston, because I'm in Boston. I'll run the query. And you'll see that this has been filtered for Boston. Right? So you're kind of giving it a filter at runtime. So let's change this. Let's just say Chicago and then run it again. And now you have all of the data for Chicago. Okay. Now, another way that you can run queries here is with a notebook-based experience. So a new the notebook interface enables users to author queries more easily by organizing multiple SQL queries and annotations in a single document. So to create a notebook, you click on the plus button here. And this interface that you see is the editor interface. So we'll just click on notebook. And now I want to do some analysis as an analyst, right? So first I'll create a markdown cell and I'll say I'm doing a quantity sold by month analysis. And then I will add a new cell, which is a SQL cell. And I'll run this particular query. All right, so we got the results back for this particular query. Now, as I look at the results, I see that December and January sales are much lower than expected. So as an analyst, I want to dig deep into it to figure out what's going on, right? So I'm going to add another markdown cell here and say number of sales in December is lower than expected. And we want to dive deep into it. And this markdown date, markdown cell, that's optional. But you add it so that when somebody else is looking at your notebook, they know what exactly you're doing. So we'll add a SQL-based cell here. And here, this particular query is just diving deep into the November and December sales, right? So we'll run this. And just like we saw before, this is better represented in a chart. So we'll create a chart. We'll make this as a calendar date, we'll make this as quantity sold, and we'll make this a bar chart. And again, we'll sort it by calendar date. All right, so now we have the data for November and December, and we see a downward trend right here, right? So this is useful information, which our marketing team maybe can use to you know, create some marketing campaigns to improve sales. So we can annotate here and say that, you know, drop in sales starting here or something like that. And then this data, this can be shared with your team or your executives or your marketing team. So for now, what I'm going to do is, you know, this analysis is very useful. So I'm going to go in and save a version of this notebook. And I'm also going to share it with my team. So now if I go into the notebooks tab, you will see that my notebook is saved. I could rename it to sales analysis. And this has also been shared with my team. And you know, anybody else in my team can come in. They can look at the version history. So right now we only have one version. And then they can create a brand new notebook from this version as well. All right. So with this, I'm going to go back into the presentation. Right here. So yeah, so in this session, we discussed how you can use Query Editor to quickly load data into a Redshift table and quickly analyze it by running queries and creating charts and sharing them with your teammates. I would, you know, suggest you try this out for yourself and see how Redshift Query Editor can be leveraged for your use cases. With that, I would like to thank you for your time. I have shared my LinkedIn profile here, so please reach out if you would like to connect or if you have any questions. Thanks again, and have a wonderful day, everyone.